This is the first video example intended to guide students of Chem 330 at the Pennsylvania State University. Today's example will cover Rayleigh's method of dimensional analysis. Our goal is to express the efficiency of a fan in terms of dimensionless parameters when we know that it is dependent on the density, the dynamic viscosity of the fluid, the angular velocity, the rotor diameter, and the discharge rate. At this point, I recommend that you pause the video and attempt to solve the problem on your own before viewing the solution. To start, we know that our efficiency is a function of these five components. So we can set the efficiency equal to the product of each of these components raised to an unknown power and multiplied by a dimensionless parameter, k. For each component in this equation, we'll want to substitute mass, length, and time dimensions. And we can determine the exponents on these dimensions by examining the units of each component. So now we rewrite the equation for efficiency in terms of dimensions, with the exponents on each dimensional term on the right-hand side corresponding to the units of each component above. And you should note that on the left-hand side, each exponent is zero, because our resulting efficiency should be dimensionless. The next step is to equate the exponents for each dimensional term on the left-hand side to those on the right-hand side. So for the mass term, we have 0 on the left-hand side. We have A from our first term on the right-hand side, and B from our second term on the right-hand side. For length, we again have 0 on the left-hand side. From the first term on the right-hand side, we have minus 3A. We have minus B from the second term. We have D from the fourth term, and 3E from the fifth term. And finally, for time, we have 0 again on the left-hand side, minus B from the second term on the right-hand side, minus C from the third term on the right-hand side, and minus E from the fifth term on the right-hand side. That gives us three equations that we can use to solve for the unknown powers in our expression for efficiency. However, we have five unknowns, which means that to move forward with our solution, we're going to have to reduce this number. We can do this by expressing some of the unknown values in terms of other unknowns. From the first equation, we have that A equals the opposite of B. From the third equation, we have that C is equal to the opposite of the quantity B plus E. And finally, from the second equation, we have that D is equal to 3A plus B minus 3E. And we can further simplify this final result by substituting our first result for A, which will give us that D is equal to negative 2B minus 3E. Now that we've reduced our number of unknowns, we return to our initial expression for efficiency and substitute for the exponents that we've redefined. This gives us an expression for efficiency with only two unknowns remaining. We can then separate our exponents so that each term has only one unknown. And finally, we group our terms under each remaining unknown exponent. Our result has two unknowns remaining. If you recall, when solving the problem, we used a system of three equations, but five unknowns, meaning that we had 2 degrees of freedom. So this will be the simplest expression that we can arrive at with the given information. I would encourage you to work today's example until you're able to solve it on your own. The problem statement was from a textbook of fluid mechanics and hydraulic machines if you're looking for similar problems. Thank you for watching.